This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Id Tech, also known as Id Tech 1 or the Doom Engine, is the game engine that powers the id Software games Doom and Doom 2, Hell on Earth. It is also used in Heretic, Hexen, Beyond Heretic, Strife, Quest for the Sigil, HACX, Twitch and Kill, Freedom, and other games produced by licensees. It was created by John Carmack, with auxiliary functions written by Micah Brash, John Romero, Dave Taylor, and Paul Roddick. Originally developed on Next Computers, it was ported to DOS for Doom's initial release and was later ported to several game consoles and operating systems. The source code to the Linux version of Doom was released to the public under a license that granted rights to non-commercial use on December 23, 1997. The source code was later re-released under the new general public license on October 3, 1999. The dozens of unofficial Doom source ports that have been created since then allow Doom to run on previously unsupported operating systems and sometimes radically expand the engine's functionality with new features. Although the engine renders a 3D space, that space is projected from a two-dimensional floor plan. The line of sight is always parallel to the floor, walls must be perpendicular to the floors, and it is not possible to create multi-level structures or sloped areas, floors and ceilings with different angles. Despite these limitations, the engine represented a technological leap from id's previous Wolfenstein 3D engine. The Doom engine was later renamed to id Tech 1 in order to categorize it in a list of id Software's long line of game engines. Contents 1 Doom level structure, 11 basic objects, 12 sectors, 13 sided Fs, 2 binary space partitioning, 3 rendering, 31 drawing the walls, 32 floor and ceiling, 33 things sprites, 4 games using the Doom engine, 5 see also, 6 notes, 7 references, 8 external links. Doom level structure: a simple setup demonstrating how Doom represents levels internally. Map view in editor viewed from the top down. All Doom levels are actually two-dimensional, demonstrating one of the key limitations of the Doom engine. Room over room is not possible. This limitation, however, has a silver lining. A map mode can be easily displayed, which represents the walls and the player's position, much like the first image to the right. Basic objects: the base unit is the vertex, which represents a single 2D point. Vertices, or vertexes as they are referred to internally, are then joined to form lines, known as linedefs. Each linedef can have either one or two sides, which are known as sidedefs. Sidedefs are then grouped together to form polygons. These are called sectors. Sectors represent particular areas of the level. Sectors: each sector contains a number of properties, a floor height, ceiling height, light level, a floor texture and a ceiling texture. To have a different light level in a particular area, for example, a new sector must be created for that area with a different light level. One-sided linedefs therefore represent solid walls, while two-sided linedefs represent bridge lines between sectors. Sidedefs. Sidedefs are used to store wall textures. These are completely separate from the floor and ceiling textures. Each sidedef can have three textures. These are called the middle, upper and lower textures in one-sided linedefs. Only the middle texture is used for the texture on the wall in two-sided linedefs. The situation is more complex. The lower and upper textures are used to fill the gaps where adjacent sectors have different floor and ceiling heights. Lower textures are used for steps. For example, the sidedefs can have a middle texture as well, although most do not. This is used to make textures hang in mid-air. For example, when a transparent bar texture is seen forming a cage, this is an example of a middle texture on a two-sided linedef. Binary space partitioning. Doom makes use of a system known as binary space partitioning, BSP. A tool is used to generate the BSP data for a level beforehand. This process can take quite some time for a large level. It is because of this that it is not possible to move the walls in Doom. While doors and lifts move up and down, none of them ever move sideways. The level is divided up into a binary tree. Each location in the tree is a node, which represents a particular area of the level, with the root node representing the entire level. At each branch of the tree, there is a dividing line which divides the area of the node into two subnodes. At the same time, the dividing line divides linedefs into line segments called SEGS. At the leaves of the tree are convex polygons, where further division of the level is not needed. These convex polygons are referred to as subsectors, or SSECTORS, and are bound to a particular sector. Each subsector has a list of SEGS associated with it. The BSP system sorts the subsectors into the right order for rendering. The algorithm is fairly simple. Start at the root node, draw the child nodes of this node, recreate recursively the child node closest to the camera is drawn first using a scanline algorithm. This can be found from looking at which side of the node's dividing line the camera is on when a subsector is reached. Draw it. The process is complete when the whole column of pixels is filled, i.e., there are no more gaps left. This ordering ensures that no time is used drawing objects that are not visible, and as a result maps can become very large without any speed penalty. Rendering. This section does not cite any sources. Please help improve this section by adding citations to reliable sources. Unsourced material may be challenged and removed. January 2012. Learn how and when to remove this template message. Drawing the walls. All of the walls in Doom are drawn vertically. It is because of this that it is not possible to properly look up and down. It is possible to perform a form of look up, down via Y shearing, and many modern Doom source ports do this, as well as later games that use the engine, such as Heretic. Essentially, this works by moving the horizon line up and down within the screen, in effect providing a window on a taller viewable area by moving the window up and down. It is possible to give the illusion of looking up and down. However, this will distort the view the further up and down the player looks. The Doom engine renders the walls as it traverses the BSP tree, drawing subsectors by order of distance from the camera so that the closest SEGS are drawn first. As the SEGS are drawn, they are stored in a linked list. This is used to clip other SEGS rendered later on, reducing overdraw. This is also used later to clip the edges of sprites once the engine reaches a solid one-sided wall at a particular X ordinate. No more lines need to be drawn at that area for clipping. The engine stores a map of areas of the screen where solid walls have been reached. This allows far away parts of the level which are invisible to the player to be clipped completely. The Doom graphic format stores the wall textures as sets of vertical columns. This is useful to the renderer, which essentially renders the walls by drawing lots of vertical columns of textures. Floor and ceiling. The system for drawing floors and ceilings flats is less elegant than that used for the walls. Flats are drawn with a flood fill-like algorithm. Because of this, it is sometimes possible if a bad BSP builder is used to get holes where the floor or ceiling bleeds down to the edges of the screen. This is also the reason that if the player travels outside of the level using the noclip cheat, the floors and ceilings will appear to stretch out from the level over the empty space. The floor and ceiling are drawn as visplanes. These represent horizontal runs of texture from a floor or ceiling at a particular height, light level, and texture. If two adjacent sectors have exactly the same floor, these can get merged into one visplane. Each X position in the visplane has a particular vertical line of texture which is to be drawn. Because of this limit of drawing one vertical line at each X position, it is sometimes necessary to split visplanes into multiple visplanes. For example, consider viewing a floor with two concentric squares. The inner square will vertically divide the surrounding floor in that horizontal range where the inner square is drawn. Two visplanes are needed for the surrounding floor. This leads to one of Doom's classic limitations which frustrated many mappers for a long time. Doom contained a static limit on the number of visplanes. If exceeded, a visplane overflow would occur, causing the game to exit to DOS with one of two messages: no more visplanes, or visplane overflow 128 or higher. The easiest way to invoke the visplane limit is a large checkerboard floor pattern. This creates a large number of visplanes as the SEGS are rendered. Visplanes are also added, extending from the edges of the SEGS towards the vertical edges of the screen. These extend until they reach existing visplanes. Because of the way this works, the system is dependent on the fact that SEGS are rendered in order by the overall engine. It is necessary to draw nearer visplanes first, so that they can cut off by others further away. If unstopped, the floor or ceiling will bleed out to the edges of the screen. As previously described, eventually, the visplanes form a map of particular areas of the screen in which to draw particular textures. While visplanes are constructed essentially from vertical strips, the actual low-level rendering is performed in the form of horizontal spans of texture. After all the visplanes have been constructed, they are converted into spans which are then rendered to the screen. This appears to be a trade-off. It is easier to construct visplanes as vertical strips, but because of the nature of how the floor and ceiling texture appear, it is easier to draw them as horizontal strips. Things sprites. Each sector within the level has a linked list of things stored in that sector. As each sector is drawn, the sprites are placed into a list of sprites to be drawn. If not within the field of view, these are ignored. The edges of sprites are clipped by checking the list of SEGS. Previously drawn sprites in Doom are stored in the same column-based format as the walls are, which again is useful for the renderer. The same functions which are used to draw walls are used to draw sprites as well. While subsectors are guaranteed to be in order, the sprites within them are not Doom stores a list of sprites to be drawn (visprites) and sorts the list before rendering. Far away sprites are drawn before close ones. This causes some overdraw, but usually this is negligible. There is a final issue of middle textures on two-sided lines, used in transparent bars. For example, these are mixed in and drawn with the sprites at the end of the rendering process, rather than with the other walls. Games using the Doom engine. The Doom engine achieved most of its fame as a result of powering the classic first-person shooter Doom, and it was used in several other games. It is usually considered that the Big Four Doom engine games are Doom, Heretic, Hexen, Beyond Heretic, and Strife, Quest for the Sigil. Games that are built directly on the Doom engine: Doom 1993, The Ultimate Doom 1995, Doom 2, Hell on Earth 1994, Master Levels for Doom 2 1995, Final Doom 1996, Heretic 1994, Heretic, Shadow of the Serpent Riders 1996, Hexen, Beyond Heretic 1995, Hexen, Death Kings of the Dark Citadel 1996, Strife, Quest for the Sigil 1996, Chex Quest 1996, Chex Quest 2, Phlemoids Take Chextropolis 1997. Games that are based on the Doom or Doom 2 code: Doom 64 1997, HACX, Twitch and Kill 1997, Cruisin' Velocity 2001, Dark Arena 2002. See also Free Software. Portal Video Games. Portal. List of game engines. First-person shooter engine: id Tech Build. Game engine: Quake Engine. Quake Series. List of first-person shooter engines. Notes: GL Nodes. Specification: Utilities to edit Doom and Doom 2. Doom engine code review by Fabian Sanglard. References: caret https://github.com/old-school/doom3do/blob/master/license caret the Doom source code, released in 1997, now under the new general public license from ID Software's FTP site. Caret the Doom source code from 3ddownloads.com, released in 1997, now under the new general public license. Caret id Tech 1 concept. Giant Bomb. Main franchises: Commander Keen, Wolfenstein, Doom, Quake. Other games: Dangerous Dave, Hovertank, 3D Catacomb, 3D Rescue Rover, Shadow Knights, Orcs. Current: Kevin Cloud, Tim Willits, Marty Stratton. Former: John Carmack, John Romero, Adrian Carmack, Tom Hall, Jay Wilbur, Mark Rain, Sandy Peterson, Dave Taylor, American McGee, Mike Wilson, Michael Abrash, Janelle Jacques, Paul Steed, Graham Devine, Todd Hollinshead, Timothy Bessett, Catherine Anna Kong, Matthew Costello. Companies: Softdisk, Apogee Software, Formgen, GT Interactive, Activision, Zenimax Media Technology, Adaptive Tile, Refresh, id Tech, Doom Engine, Quake Engine, Quake 2 Engine, id Tech 3, id Tech 4, id Tech 5, id Tech 6, GTK, Radiant Related, QuakeCon, Masters of Doom VE, Doom Series, Main Series, Doom 1993, Official Versions Development, Doom 2, Hell on Earth, Final Doom, Doom 3, Resurrection of Evil, BFG Edition, Doom 2016, Spin-offs, Doom 64, Doom RPG, Doom Resurrection, Doom 2 RPG Novels, Doom Novels, Doom 3, Worlds on Fire, Doom 3, Maelstrom. Other media: Doom, The Board Game Film Universe, BFG 9000, Cyber Demon, Doomguy, Gravity Gun Technology, Doom Engine. Source ports: id Tech 4, id Tech 6, WAD Related, DWANGO, Chex Quest, id Software, Marine, Doom, Wolfenstein 3D Book, Doom Series. Category: Doom Portal, Video Games v. E Game Engines. List source port: First Person Shooter Engine. List Tile Engine. Game Engine Recreation. List Game Creation System. Free and Open Source 2D Adventure Game Studio. Beats of Rage, Cocos 2D, Flixel, Joger, Kirikiri, LibGDX, MoIO, HRRPGCE, OpenFLORX, Pygame, Renpy, Strategus, 1000 Parsec, Vassal, XCONQ, 25D, Aleph, 1Cube, 3D, Away, 3D, Blender Game, CAFU, Crystal Space, Cube 2, Delta 3D, Dim 3, Goo Create, Glycine Horde 3D, HPL 1, Earlicht, id Tech 3, id Tech 4, J Monkey, Ogre, Open Wonderland, Panda 3D, Papervision 3D, Platinum Arts, Sandbox, Free 3D Game Maker, PlayCanvas, PLIB, Quake, Quake 2, RealmForge, Retribution, Torque 3D Mix, Allegro, Construct, Classic, Godot, Lightweight, Java Game Library, Spring, Wintermute Engine, Proprietary 2D Construct 2, Corona, ClickTeam, Fusion Game Maker, Studio Game Salad, Muggin, N Scripter, RPG Maker, Southpaw, Stencil, Ubiart Framework, Vicious Virtual Theater, V Play, Zillions of Games, 3D 4A, Amazon Lumberyard, Anvil, Bork 3D, C4, Chrome, Clausewitz Engine, Creation, CryEngine, Crystal Tools, Diesel, Dunia, EAGL, Ego, Elflight, Enforce, Enigma, Essence, Flare 3D, Fox, Frostbite, GeoMod, Golds, RC Hero Engine Hydro Engine HPL 2-3 ID Tech 5 ID Tech 6 Ignite IW Jade Kinetica LS 3D Lithtech Luminous Studio Lin Marmalade Mizuchi Mount Framework Outera Panta Ray Fiery Engine Q Real Virtuality Redengine Refractor Riot Rage Sage Sirius Shark 3D Shiva Silent Storm Source Titan Toshi TrueVision 3D Unigen Unity Unreal Vision Visual 3D XN Gine X-Ray Yeti Zero Mix Gamebryo Hybrid Graphics Kineva Game Platform Metismo Historical Interest Brender Build Dark Doom Game Maker GameMaker Gary Kitchens GameMaker Genesis 3D Genie Filmation Freescape Insane Jedi Made Pie in the Sky Renderware Sim RPG Maker Sith Voxel Space Wolfenstein 3D Proprietary Middleware List Euphoria Gameware Gameworks Havoc iMuse Kinapse Quazzle Speedtree Zaitment FaceGen